you know, I think what's interesting, of course, here is the third-time final had proved the charm, but it's been an awfully long road to get here, as you well know. And having followed every step of the way, I can certainly tell you that as well. This is a combination that many thought would have taken place at this point years ago, but was stymied for a variety of reasons. The first time around, after Sherry Redstone had obviously taken back, in a sense, not control of the company, but taken over her father's affairs and control of the company through that way a number of years back, and gotten rid of Philippe Domon as the CEO, there was an expectation that it would move very quickly to a deal with CBS. They were unable to agree at that point on social issues, but as much on economics. Fast forward, try again, as we well know, and as I detailed time in and day out, of course, the problems that they had in trying to get a deal through. Leslie Moonves, who wanted full control in terms of his ability to appoint the number two, in addition to being, of course, CEO of the combined company. And then Mr. Moonves making the unprecedented decision to pursue his controlling shareholder and the ultimate litigation that followed. And then Mr. Moonves's ouster, of course, with charges of sexual misconduct. Fast forward yet another year. And frankly, this time last year, there was an expectation that early this year they would start those talks, Melissa. And they finally got there. Many of us expected they would have announced the deal as soon as March or April of this year. But CBS's board really took its time this time, going over every single thing they possibly could, demanding certain things in terms of the composition of the combined company's board, and focusing on those social issues prior to getting to the economics, which they were able to deal with in a relatively quick fashion over these last few days. So here we are, Melissa, but the question, of course, is how much has the landscape even changed since they first contemplated putting these two companies back together? Of course, they had been partners, if you will, for roughly 5 years until Mr. Redstone decided to split them apart.
The stocks are barely moving on the back of this, although slightly positive for each of them, David. And perhaps it's to your point that this deal had been long anticipated. The call, I understand, is at 4:30 p.m. this afternoon. In your mind, what are some of the outstanding questions still for this new management team?
Yeah, I think, you know, obviously, given all the reporting that has taken place prior to this final announcement or the announcement today, as you point out, the stocks had already adjusted to a certain extent. We're reflecting an expectation of an exchange ratio that came in more or less in, within the realm of what many anticipated. But the key questions now are, do they still have enough scale? Can they really compete in a world that you talk about every day, Melissa, when you discuss Netflix and when we discuss, of course, Disney, which is now the owner of Fox, soon to be launching its own direct-to-consumer service that is going to be quite significant. CBS has started All Access. Viacom has an AVOD, an advertising-supported video-on-demand service called Pluto that it purchased earlier this year and is trying to grow quickly. But, you know, are these enough to compete in what we know are these rapidly changing times? That remains a key question, as do the simple things. For example, the CBS NFL contract. Yes, it's not up until 2022. But the fact is that oftentimes they can begin to renegotiate those a year or even 2 years in advance. Who is CBS going to be meeting on the playing field to compete for those rights? And will they be an even better capitalized competitor, even with Viacom in the fold? So there are plenty of questions, although I will say Viacom was able to answer a key one that existed a year ago, which was, of course, would it re-up in its affiliate agreements? It did manage to do that. The economics of which remain very foggy. We don't really always get the exact nature or terms of those deals, but at least they got the deals done in terms of the carriage agreements that they had outstanding.